See children, so we have completed imperatives, rule 1 and 2 in the last class, and we need to introduce interrogatives this day, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes,
ma'am. So yes, listen, ma'am. We are concluding our grammar topic for your MCQ 3 examination today. So let me introduce an interrogative sentence, the way how to change an interrogative sentence from active voice to passive voice. Okay? Okay.
Yes,
okay. Ma'am, so what are called interrogative sentences?
Included in our MCQ 3 examination.
Active and passive voice are there. Definitely it is there. I hope that you have received the chart. That means the time.
Yes,
ma'am, I see this, right?
Yes, ma'am. We have written the timetable.
Not clear.
Ma'am, I am asking that imperative passive is there in our MCQ.
Yes, yes. Except interrogative, you are going to write declarative and imperatives. Okay. Interrogatives won't be here. Interrogatives, anyway, I am going to teach interrogatives today, but it is not included. Active and passive is declarative and imperatives are there. Interrogatives are excluded. As it is a little tougher, you need more time for drilling. See children, interrogative sentences. Before jumping into interrogative sentences from active to passive transformation, let me ask you a question. Are you thorough with the tense forms?
Yes, ma'am.
Are
yes,
you ma'am. Able to identify the tense forms by looking at the verb?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Otherwise, there is no use for you to get trained. Okay. So if it is not completed, if you are not thorough with the tense forms, you need more drilling to identify the tense forms, to identify the active voice sentence and into passive voice. Okay, now listen, interrogative sentences, you know, interrogatives are used for asking questions. Agree?
Yes, ma'am. Agree.
Okay, there are two types of interrogative sentences. Okay, we can to gather information, to collect some information. I can start my interrogative sentence with the WH word. What is your name? If this question to Fidel Babu, just see Fidel Babu. This question is actually to Fidel Babu. Fidel, how old are you?
Ma'am, I am 12 years old.
Okay, Adal Krishna, tell me which is your favorite color?
Ma'am, white.
White. So peaceful mind. Okay, agree. Okay, so Al Asfan, where are you living now?
Ma'am, Kudungalur Chapara.
Kudungalur. Oh, great. Okay. Anlin, what is your favorite book?
Ma'am, Tom and Jerry.
Tom and Jerry. That is a cartoon. Is that a book available?
Yes,
Tom and Jerry. Vaiga, whom do you like the most, father or mother? Question.
Ma'am,
your mama is near, so tell mama's name. If your father is there with you, tell father's name, so there won't be any clash. Okay, so Vaiga, tell me whom do you like the most?
Ma'am, I like both.
Excellent, a good daughter you are. You like your father and mother equally, there is no preference, right?
Yeah,
okay,
ma'am.
So Aldous, my son, tell me who is your role model? See, don't tell my name. Don't tell my name. I don't like, okay? If you tell my name, definitely I'll give you a chocolate. Okay. Okay, tell me, real hero. Your hero in your life. Whom do you want to copy in your life? Your father, maybe your choice, like a very great person's.
Ma'am, my parents.
Your parents, excellent. They are the strong pillars to build yourself into the heights,
yes, ma'am.
Right? So,
yes.
Hannah, Rashida. Who is sitting next to you?
Ma'am, my sister.
My sister. See, I have asked different questions to different people and they said different answers. Okay. All these questions are starting with the WH word in English grammar, isn't it?
Yes, ma'am.
These questions are called WH questions, which I am, or the person who is asking a question, collects or gathers some information from the person who is listening to him or her. Okay, so WH question, first type of question. Second type of questions are called yes or no questions. Okay, where the person who is asking a question is expecting an answer, either yes or no from the listener. See, Gautam Krishna is here. Gautam?
Yes,
Gautam, are you coming with me, Gautam? To my home?
Confused.
If I go with ma'am, definitely she will be sitting and teaching me the grammar whole day. So better escape. Right? No. Then tell me, I want an answer. Are you coming with me? Okay, not to home. Are you coming with me for a small evening party in Lulu Mall? Confused? I want an answer fast. He is confused. He's thinking, okay, if I agree, my mother will not agree. So better keep mum. Okay, Ridha Masan, you're my neighbor. You're in North Parur, nearby. So Ridha, can we go for a small trip to Ernakulam? Let me ask my father and mother. No, I will ask. Don't worry. Ridha Masan, we'll go for a short trip to Lulu Mall.
Yes,
no quarantine? Yes, ma'am. So I got a reply. Yes, he's ready. Okay, whenever I'm going, I'll definitely call you. So my next question to Ihan. Ihan is thinking, this ma'am is asking nothing to me. Ihan, am I mad? Ihan?
Yes,
I am a little mad. See, he said the truth. He did not even hear the question and he said, yes, ma'am is a little, eccentric. She is insane and she is, yes, you said yes. I can take only the first one, first answer. You said yes, so I agree, I'm a little. Okay, so children, I'm getting yes or no from you guys. Arita said, yes, ma'am, I am coming with you. And Ihan said, ma'am, you are crack. Okay, that's also I admit. No problem for that. Okay, children. So these are the yes or no questions. The person who is asking a question is expecting either yes or no from the listeners. Clear? Am I clear?
Yes, clear.
Okay, fine. So we can convert these two types of questions or these types of two questions into passive voice form. See, remember, there is no strict rules to use when you convert an active voice interrogative sentence into passive voice. Okay, but a few points that you should remember. So point number one, if your interrogative sentences are starting with the do forms, what are the do forms in English grammar?
Do, does, did.
Do.
Excellent. Do, does, did. Adi Ishwar, are you listening to the class? You have many cousin brothers and sisters at your backside and they are disturbing you guys. Push them.
Yes,
push them out of the room and close the door. Tell them don't attack me like this, guys. Right? So children, okay, please listen. Listen carefully. So we cannot use do. See, almost all the questions of interrogative questions are ending with a question mark. Agree?
Yes, ma'am.
If your active voice interrogative question is ending with a question mark, when you convert the question into passive voice, the passive voice question also should be ending with a question mark. Agree?
Agree, ma'am.
So you can see a question at the end of active voice interrogative question, and also after converting the same question into passive voice, that passive voice sentence also ending with a question mark. That is point number one. Point number two, if your interrogative questions are starting with the do, does, did. Okay, remember, if your interrogative sentences are starting with the do, does, did, you cannot use do, does, did in the beginning position or in a passive voice sentence. If we are not using do, does, and did in a passive voice sentence, what can we use instead of this? Any idea, guys? No idea, ma'am. No idea, right?
Other form.
Auxiliary verb. So instead of do, doesn't, did, which auxiliary verbs can be used? Guess first. Try to guess.
Ma'am or does.
Have.
Vaiga?
Ma'am, have.
No. Okay, as you don't, as you are not, see, as you are not familiar with the answer, let me tell you, instead of do, does, and did, if your question is beginning with do, does, or did in an active voice, which cannot be, or which cannot be used in passive voice, so instead of these two forms, you can use be forms. Am, is, are, was, where, according to the tenses, according to the subject, okay? So instead of do, does, and did, when you convert a sentence from active voice to passive voice, you can use am, is, are, was, where in passive. Clear?
Yes, ma'am. Clear.
Am I clear? It is more clear when you when we do some exercises today. Okay. So next point. Next point. Listen. If your sentence, if your question is starting with has, have, had, which is called the have forms in English, you can begin your has, have, had forms. You can begin your passive voice sentence with the has, have, had forms. There is no need for changing it. Okay, so only one condition, if your sentence is starting with do, does, and did, which cannot be used to begin your passive voice sentence. Instead of do, does, and did, you must use be forms, am, is, are, was, where, according to the tenses and according to the subject in passive voice. Second point, if your sentence in active voice, interrogative, is starting with have, has, and had, you can begin your passive voice sentence with the same have, has, and had. Okay, we don't want to change it. And my third point, if your active voice interrogative sentences are starting with the will, would, can, could, shall, should, may, might, and must. That means these are called modal auxiliaries, right?
Yeah, ma'am.
If your sentences are starting with a modal auxiliary verb, the same model can be used to begin your passive voice sentence when you convert such an active voice sentence into passive voice sentence. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Am I clear?
It's very clear.
Okay. And the last point, see children, WH words are called what, which, where, when, why. Okay. But who is a WH word and whom is also a WH word. But we cannot include this who and whom with these WH words. So except who and whom, the rest of the WH words can be used to begin your passive voice sentence. But only one condition, if your active voice sentence is starting with who, when you convert that who into passive, you should begin your passive voice sentence with by whom. Okay, at the same time, if your active voice sentence is starting with whom, now when you transform the sentence into passive voice, you can use the word who in passive voice. I know that this is not clear, so with the help of a slide, I'm going to explain once again. See, children. So let us begin once again. Let us discuss once again passive voice interrogative. This is not there for the exam. Okay. This point is not there for the exam, only imperatives. But still, you need a clarity for doing some of the activities or some of the worksheet exercises. So my dear children, listen here. See, these are the important points that you should remember. Okay, if your sentence is starting, active voice sentence is starting with the do, does, or did. A question. So it does not appear in the passive form. Instead of that, you should begin your passive voice sentence with am or is or are or was or where according to the tenses. See, am, is, are can be used with the present tense. Was, where can be used with the past tense. Clear?
Clear.
If you look at the second point, if your sentence is starting with has, have, had, according to the subject. If the subject is singular, use has. If the subject is plural in present tense, use have. Okay. According to the subject, we can begin the say, or we can use the same words to begin our passive voice sentence. At the same time, the modal auxiliaries like can, may, will, shall, would, and etc. And the WH words like when, where, why, how, and what. It does not change its beginning position when an active voice is changed into passive voice. You can use the same modal auxiliaries to begin your passive voice. You can use the same question words, WH words to begin your passive voice. At the same time, if your active voice sentence is starting with the word who, okay? If it is starting with the word who, when you change this who into passive voice, you should begin your passive voice sentence with by whom, okay? Who killed the snake? Who, example, see, who killed the snake? This is your question. Passive active voice question is who killed the snake? Okay, question one. How can you change this question? This who is changed into by whom in passive. Okay, and you know, killed is showing that the sentence is given in simple past tense. Okay, so by whom was, object becomes subject. By whom was snake, past participle form of the verb.
Killed by.
Killed. And put a question mark at the end. I know this is not up to your level. This is a little difficult, but still you need to learn this. Okay? It is easy. So who is changed into by whom? Okay? And also if your active voice sentence is whom did you invite? See, whom did you invite? This is an interrogative sentence starting with WH word, and did invite shows that the sentence is in simple past tense. Okay? Okay? So how can I change the sentence into passive? Who is that, Aldous? Your little brother?
Yes, ma'am.
What is his name?
Ma'am, Aldrin.
Aldrin. Nice to meet you, Aldrin. Has gone. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Nice to meet you, Aldrin. Went again. Hello, Aldrin. So are you here to disturb your elder brother? Aldrin, hello, Aldrin. Hi. So you can leave. Okay, bye-bye. Okay. See, children, so let us see. Whom did you invite? Whom did you invite? So if you are beginning your active voice sentence with whom, when you change the sentence into passive voice, whom is changed into who? So who did invite shows that the sentence in simple past tense, who was invited by you. Okay, put a question mark at the end. Am I clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Clear. I think somewhat clear. Okay. Do you have any doubt here?
No, ma'am.
No doubt.
It's clear. Fully clear.
Fully clear.
I have a good Steve.
No, ma'am. Can you explain again?
Which word? Definitely. I'm
ma'am,
here
the
to
second
explain.
One.
Okay. So I'll do one thing. Let me take a sheet again. See, you can see a few examples written on the board. Okay. See, did she recognize? See, I'm just rubbing it. I'm not using it. I don't want you to show you the answers. So I'm just rubbing it. Okay. See, did she recognize you? See, children, the question is, did she recognize you? This is your question, isn't it?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. We are going to change the sentence into passive voice. Okay. First step. Identify the verb and tell me the tense of the sentence. Unmute and tell me.
Ma'am, simple past.
How did you get it? Your answer is right.
Ma'am, recognize.
Ma'am, recognize.
Only recognize.
Did recognize.
The word did recognize shows that the sentence is an example for simple past tense. Okay, simple past. So we got the tense, right? We know that this is an interrogative because it has a question mark at the end. Agree?
Yes,
and subject of the sentence.
Yes,
subject
ma'am.
Of the sentence. Tell me the subject of the sentence.
Ma'am, did she?
Did is a verb.
Ma'am, did she?
She, very good. She is the subject of the sentence. Object of the sentence? Ma'am, you.
You.
Excellent. You is the object of the sentence. So we have got the verb, did, recognize. We have got the subject. We have got the object. Okay, we understood the sentence is in simple past tense. So how are we going to change this active voice sentence into passive voice? See, children, I have told you, we cannot begin our passive voice sentence with did. Right? Instead of do forms, I should begin my sentence with be forms. Isn't it?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Okay. So, and also according to active voice and passive voice transformation, we should interchange the position of subject with object and object with subject. Ready? Agree?
Agree.
Okay. So, what is the subject of your passive voice here?
Ma'am was.
No.
Ma'am was.
No, no, no. Object of the passive voice.
You.
You.
Okay. You, the object becomes the subject. Okay, you.
Yes.
As you is the subject of the passive voice, I should begin my question either with the WH word or with an auxiliary verb. This is the pattern. See, there is a pattern for setting a question, right? The pattern for setting a question is question word plus auxiliary verb plus subject plus main verb. Okay, and at the end you can see a question mark. This is the order for framing a question. Okay, here the question word is absent, so I should begin with an auxiliary verb. As I have told you, I cannot begin my passive voice sentence with do, does, and did. So if it is not possible for me to use do forms, I should have to use be forms instead of this, right?
Yes, ma'am.
What are the be forms,
ma'am?
Okay, so children, as you said, the sentence is in simple past tense. You said, ma'am, you have written the sentence in simple past tense, isn't it?
Yes, ma'am.
Isn't it?
Yes.
Yes.
So I cannot use am, is, or here, isn't it?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
So ma'am, which is what I should select here?
Was.
Ma'am,
was.
It is you after was. Was you is a right usage.
Ma'am, are.
Ma'am, are.
Oh, this is simple past tense.
Ma'am, we can't use.
We can't use was with you. You was a student. See, listen. If I say the sentence like this, you was my best student. You may be throwing stones at me.
No, ma'am, you were.
Ma'am, was you.
You were. You were, right? You was is wrong usage. You were is the right usage. Okay? So, or which auxiliary verb you can use to begin your sentence? This is in simple past tense. So, be forms possible is was or were. As you is the subject of this interrogative sentence, passive voice, I can use only were before you. Okay? Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes.
Were you?
Okay, ma'am.
Were you? Tell me now.
Recognize.
Be form plus past participle form. So, recognize become
recognized
by
her.
Excellent. And what punctuation
by
mark?
Her.
What punctuation mark?
Ma'am, question mark.
Question mark.
Put a question mark. Agree?
Yes, ma'am.
Clear. A little clear. See. There is a small error. I have written she here. So here it should be you. So where you recognized by her. Clear? Clear?
Yes, ma'am. Clear.
So I'm just deleting. I'm just erasing. I'm just overwriting on the answer there. See, look at the sentence here. Who wrote this book? See, children, let me write the question here next to this. I request everybody's patience. You wait. Okay. So the question is, who wrote this book? Okay. It is an interrogative sentence. And tell me the tense of the sentence.
Ma'am, simple
past. Simple past. Trot is the verb and the sentence is in simple past. Agree?
Yes, ma'am. Agree.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Okay. So let us convert the sentence into passive voice. I have told you, if your active voice sentence is given or it is starting with the word who, when we convert the word who into passive voice, instead of who, what should I use here?
Whom.
Ma'am, by whom?
By whom? Okay. By, I should begin my sentence with by whom. Okay.
By whom?
By who?
By who?
By the whom? Object of the active voice becomes subject. So by whom?
Was the book.
What? Ah, by whom? Was, it is simple past tense. Was this book? By whom was this book?
Written.
Excellent. Excellent. You got it? Written. And punctuation mark?
Question mark.
Very good. So who becomes or who is changed into by whom in passive voice? As it is simple past tense, auxiliary verb was must be used. See, was plus or be form plus past participle form. Be plus past participle form of the verb is used here. Clear?
Yes.
And object of the active voice becomes the subject here. Agree?
Yes.
Who is changed into by whom in passive voice? Agree?
Yes, agree.
Okay, so these are the changes. Okay, these are the things that you should by heart, you should learn, you should identify. Okay, and another sentence, look at here. Have you, this is a tricky, very tricky question. Have you heard the news? This is a question. See, children, have you heard the news? This is an interrogative sentence starting with have. So how can I change the sentence into passive voice? Can you help me?
First step,
identify the tense of the sentence.
Simple past.
Yes, Vidal. Have heard. Okay. Have heard shows that the sentence is an example for present perfect. Agree?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So we got the tense of the sentence. And tell me the subject of the sentence.
Ma'am, you.
Ma'am,
yes.
Yes.
So you is the subject of the sentence. Okay, tell me the object of the sentence.
The news.
Excellent. The news is the object of the sentence. Okay, so we have got the subject, we have got the object, we have got the tense form. Now, change the sentence from active voice to passive voice.
You got it,
Aldous. So you please tell me.
Has
subject and object interchanging?
Ma'am, the news.
You.
Has the news. See, remember you have a table with you. Check the table of present tense, present perfect tense. All of you check the table of present perfect tense, passive voice.
Wonderful.
Has the news been heard
by you?
Very good. Written. So you're getting it. Written by you. Wonderful. Good children you are. Put a question mark. Okay. This is how you should identify an interrogative sentence. This is how you need to convert one interrogative sentence from active voice to the passive voice. Still you can ask me. No worries.
Ma'am, in the last sentence, I have a doubt. Can you show the board again?
Sure, why not? Okay, look at this. Look at the board and ask me the doubt.
Clear? Ma'am, you are conducting written by you.
How written came?
How written came?
Yes, ma'am.
You are not familiar with the past participle form usage?
She is right.
Not written.
It's
yes,
called.
You are absolutely right. Seba, thank you. Thank you, Seba. The question was, have you heard the news? Not written. So what can you enter there?
Has the news been heard?
Okay. Heard. Heard. Okay, fine. Has the news been heard by you? Thank you. Thank you, Seba. Because it was there written in your present perfect books. That is why the same mistake happened here. That is okay. Okay. See, children. Timely approach. Good. I appreciate that, Seba. +5 for you. Okay. So another question. Okay, now look at the next question, children. Let me take another question for you. So we are coming to an end. See. Will you help him? Okay. Will you help him? I'm going to write. Will you help him? Put a question mark at the end. Okay, the sentence is in active voice. So tell me the tense of the sentence.
Ma'am, simple future.
Yes, you're right. How did you get it?
Ma'am, because you are in the base form of the verb.
Will?
Ma'am, base form of the verb.
So tell me the verb.
Help.
Will help. Help. Okay.
Ma'am will so, help. Help.
Will help. So the sentence is in simple future. Agree.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Okay. So simple future. We have got the sentence in simple future. Subject of the sentence?
Ma'am,
you.
Subject of the sentence? The subject and him is the object.
Him. Okay. So we got the tense. We got the verb. We got the subject. We have got the object. Okay. We are going to change the sentence into passive voice. I have told you, if your sentence is starting with a modal auxiliary, you can begin your passive voice sentence with the same modal auxiliary verb. So how are you planning to begin your sentence?
Will.
Okay, so we got will. We got a question word. Will.
Will he.
The object becomes the subject, so we should change it into
will
he.
Will he.
See, it's a simple future. So look at the passive voice box of the sentence.
Help by you.
Very good.
Help by you.
Help.
Okay. And punctuation
mark.
Question mark. Got it. I'm glad. Okay. So children, again, I'm repeating. Our exams, MCQ 3 exams are coming. It is very close. 17th or 16th English grammar examination for you, I think. See, children. So the topics for you to cover is kinds of sentences. Declarative, imperative, interrogative and exclamatory sentences identification. And simple, complex, compound sentences identification. Active and passive voice. 3 boxes of tenses and also imperatives. Okay. So concentrate on these topics. Study well, prepare well. And if you have any doubt, you can call me after 7:30, between 7:30 to 8 o'clock every day evening. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.